I haven't seen the movie, but the main thing I just kept thinking about was how hilarious it would be to get you this shirt. Maybe Tom Cruise has got to get you this one. Would you rock this one? It's not just Jack.
I couldn't rock it, dude.
No, but I love that it's so specific. Also, how did they decide this? Louisville, Kentucky with special guest May 15th, 2009.
Well, maybe he's from there, his character. Oh, yeah, because there's a scene when he's hanging out with Dave Chappelle, and I think that's back...
Back in Louisville?
In, like, where he's from. Have you seen the film, Seinfeld?
I saw it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Thoughts?
Yeah, I also had low expectations, and yeah, I enjoyed it. I don't think I enjoyed it as much as you did.
Uh-huh.
But I liked it.
I just like this shirt because it's one step beyond. I guess there's, like, levels. You can get a shirt that's kind of like, I'm a fan of this thing, and then you can get a shirt that's kind of like, I'm such a fan of this thing, I want a shirt that kind of makes it seem like I live in the world of the movie.
Right.
And this one is like, I'm so deep into the world of the movie that I'm actually exploring like the outer reaches.
It's like fan fiction.
I'm exploring the Jackson Maine universe, the JMU.
Are there other examples of from like realistic films of like fan fiction merch?
There's the Axe Capital Billions t-shirt.
Nice.
Comes to mind.
Oh yeah, well yeah. Exactly. It's kind
of, but that's
kind,
not like they're not pushing it.
It's
they're
like
not,
it's like you could go to the NBC store at Rockefeller Center and you could get a shirt of Michael Scott from The Office,
right?
Saying some like classic Michael Scott type line and just right. wear that, and people be like, oh, you like The Office, and then you could get a shirt that says The Office. You get a shirt that says Dunder Mifflin.
Okay,
it's like a little.
Well, it's like semi plausibly realistic if that universe existed.
Yeah, exactly.
If the Office universe existed,
they would have Dunder Mifflin t-shirts.
You wouldn't have a t-shirt with Michael Scott on it.
Exactly. As a fan of a fictional universe, the t-shirt you choose shows...
It has to exist within that universe.
It shows what reality you want to live in. There's people who are like, I enjoy The Office. It's a funny program. I like to flip it on. Takes my cares away. And there's other people who are like, I live in The Office universe.
That's why Ghostbusters... shirts always kind of worked, like the simple,
because they're both at once. Yeah, kind
it's,
of
it's the simple shirt with just the logo, but in the film the Ghostbusters become celebrities and like are like a hot thing in New York for a second, and people are rocking in the fictional universe of the film, people are wearing shirts with the Ghostbusters logo,
right?
So it's like when you wear that, it's like you might have been a fan in the fictional universe of
right.
the film. But like a lot of movies, like what could you do, like in Lebowski?
Right.
There probably is like fictional merch you could wear.
Yeah. You get like a Harry Potter shirt that says like property of Gryffindor, as if like
Jesus.
You bought it at the Gryffindor gift shop. Like,
right.
Like it's a real place.
Yeah. I don't know about this Jackson Maine tee.
Anyway, we're going to get it for you. Where are you going to wear it to? Would you wear? Okay. Let's
I
say
wouldn't
we,
wear it. I'll be honest with you. Okay. I love like free t-shirts.
So let's say we drop. The Time Crisis crew drops $35 plus shipping and handling on this t-shirt. We get it for you. It's a high quality shirt. Nice cotton. Feels good. Fits great.
Very soft.
Very soft. You're not going
to
wear it?
I would wear it to a taping of the show.
That's it?
Yeah.
You're wearing a Sweet Martha's cookie jar sweatshirt right now.
I know. I have so much merch. Actually, I was saying this the other day. My wardrobe right now is like, it's either like Time Crisis... or Vampire Weekend, or Little Wings, or Richard Pictures based.
Or Sweet Martha's.
Or Sweet Martha's. Well, that's kind of like TC Universe.
Yeah, true.
Because I have three Sweet Martha's shirts. I have 8-Minute Cape Cod. That's a classic. Mm-hmm. I've been wearing my Father's Day Weekend, Vampire Weekend.
Oh, yeah. I've seen you wear
long
that
sleeve
out in the wild.
A
looks,
lot.
That looks great.
It's kind of cooling down a little bit in LA. Yeah. And I've got countless Little Wings and Richard Pictures shirts.
And all those shirts, you never think twice about throwing on?
No. They're cool, man. But like, just like walking into like...
I agree.
They're like Civil Coffee down the street from me. I'm just like wearing like a Jackson Maine tee. I mean, that does show
that's
that
sick.
I do.
That's sick.
I don't think of myself as a guy that's super, self-conscious about my appearance in
but
public.
But you would be that, self-conscious.
That would... That's pushing it.
Would you wear an Alley shirt?
No, man.
Would you wear a shirt that says Bradley Cooper and it's a picture of Bradley Cooper directing A Star Is Born?
Like, was that sure that you're more in touch with consensus reality?
I like that. I like that interpretation.
Wait, let's get one that's just like picture Bradley Cooper, says Bradley Cooper, and on the back it says director of A Star Is Born.
That'd be solid.
You'd rock that?
And it's him like in an editing booth or something.
Or no, if it was, yeah, that's funny. Or maybe that's the back of the shirt, and then the front of the shirt is him as Jackson Maine. You know what would be really dope? Like, take it deep. Like, find a picture of like a young Bradley Cooper from like when he was like 18 in like the mid 90s, and then just like have like make a shirt from like Jackson Maine live at the Troubadour, July 22nd, 1996. Like, really go deep. And it's like a very young Bradley Cooper. Like, you know, like in the role of a very young Jackson Maine.
Opening.
Because he's had a 25-year career.
Yeah.
Yeah, opening.
Opening for Eddie Vedder. For Eddie Vedder, solo ukulele show at the Troubadour, 1998.
Oh, no, that's even deeper. You make an Eddie Vedder t-shirt. Solo to her. And then and very small text at the bottom says, with special guest Jackson Maine.
You notice you make an Austin City Limits 2005 festival shirt just with like whatever it is on the front. And then in the back, just very subtly, you change it to Jackson Maine.
Like 35th listed performer.
You know,
it's
man.
It's all just spot on realistic. Taking the Jackson Maine merch to just a granular level of detail.
Okay, what about, this is probably the coolest Jackson Maine shirt. This one, the one I'm showing Jake now, it kind of looks like an actual vintage, like Bob Seger shirt from the 70s. Would you rock this one?
Oh, man.
I mean, you love the film.
It's the best looking shirt of the ones we've seen. But you know what's funny? I couldn't rock it because, well, it's still from the film, but also because of the time period in which the film is set, it automatically becomes, this is like a reissue.
A fake retro shirt
that you'd see at like Target.
Yeah.
You didn't buy this. Jackson Maine wasn't touring in 1980.
Yeah.
You know, does a whole like other uncanny valley.
Do you think that they're going to continue making albums as Jackson Maine? Like, is this to keep going?
I think Bradley Cooper is too, he would find that corny. That's my guess.
And he's right to find that corny.
Keep expanding the Star Is Born universe.
Sequel.
I could totally picture like somebody right now putting together a deal. Bradley Cooper, Lady Gaga.
Tour. Oh, yeah, dude.
Arena tour. As Jackson Maine and Allie.
Wow. Would people go? I mean, Gaga's huge.
Yeah,
so.
Well, Gaga's got a built-in thing. And with this, they'd have to do it soon. Who are some other fictional musicians they could get in?
Jeff Bridges from Crazy Heart. Real mellow.
We got Jackson Maine Alley with special guest Jeff Bridges from Crazy Heart.
Mark Wahlberg from Rockstar. What other fictional musicians? That's a good one. Blues Brothers. That's a good one. What, John Goodman?
Yeah.
And Dan Aykroyd?
The John Goodman reboot.
Jackson Maine with Miles Teller from Whiplash on drums. Is that something?
Whiplash long sleeve.